Hey there! Welcome to another episode of Dear Blocko, the show where I answer your questions about your world and my world. Just a heads up, QBOT requested they switch to their mobile body, so they have a better chance at finding love. My animator said he made a few tweaks to the design, but I'm not sure I notice a difference. Anyway, first question up. Ugh, jeez, QBOT, is that how you print stuff out now? Animator, we have to change that. Ooh, this is a spooky one. Rashida M. asks, Dear Blocko, can you do a video on locked-in syndrome? Brace yourselves, people. Locked-in syndrome, or LIS, is a rare neurological disorder. It's caused by damage to a part of the brainstem called the pons. This connects the lower brainstem with the cerebellum, which is responsible for physical movement and facial control. This results in the paralysis of all voluntary muscles except for the eyes. People with the disorder can't move their bodies, make facial expressions, speak, or chew and swallow. But they can move their eyes up and down, blink, and hear. And their cognitive abilities, like thinking and reasoning, are still intact. There's no cure currently, but thanks to supportive therapy to help with breathing and eating, and communication training, those affected often live happy and fulfilling lives. Second question up. Oh, no, don't do the crouch, Okay. Let's see. Happy Squeeb asks, can you explain how and why the Uncanny Valley exists? Well, the concept of the Uncanny Valley was introduced in the 1970s by Tokyo Institute of Technology professor Masahiro Mori. He noticed that when making robots more and more lifelike, there comes a point where they stop becoming more appealing and start making people feel uneasy, or even scared, like some people in the Life Noggin universe. Gonna go over here. While there is no definitive reason why people feel uncomfortable around robots that almost look human, there are many theories. For instance, a 2019 study on the brain patterns of 21 people tasked with looking at robots and humans found that certain areas of the brain evaluated the subject based on a specific feature combination that led to their response. Others theorize that this fear comes from an evolutionary response to avoid anyone behaving not quite normal, in case, you know, they're diseased. Whatever the reason is, I know I don't like it when I see it. And now it's time for a question about me or my world. Can you please make the paper come out anywhere else? Oh, for the love of animator. Now, give me that. Sudie Patty asks, Dear Blocko, will QBOT ever find love? Okay, alright, fine. I'll answer this. Yes. I'm sure QBOT will find love if I install the Love and Longing expansion pack, but please, you can't give QBOT any more weird ideas. They get all their data from the comment section. They're already obsessed with anime and whatever the heck the back rooms are they keep talking about, but I'll do it. I want QBOT to be happy. No, that's not a potential love interest, QBOT. That is a gumball machine. You know what? Who am I to judge? Live your truth. So, do you have any questions about your world and my world? Let me know in the comment section below and use hashtag Dear Blocko so I can find it. Want to watch even more Dear Blocko? Check out the previous one we did. Or watch this video. Don't forget to subscribe, hit the bell, and like, because it really helps us out. Check out the amazing work done by Lifespan.io, the team that powers Life Noggin, down in the description. As always, my name is Blocko. This has been Life Noggin. Don't forget to keep on thinking.